What's a no-deal Brexit going to mean for the food we eat? Welcome to Brexplainers. The first thing we need to say about leaving the European Union with no deal is whatever area of our national life you're looking at, it's uncertainty that will hit. No one's done anything like this before because no deal means that loads of laws that govern how we interact with the EU simply cease to exist. Leaving with nothing agreed is going to lead to checks on the border when we try and sell things to the European Union, and that's going to have a massive impact. First and foremost, however, if the ports back up, then all those people who either import or export fresh produce are in for a problem because slight delays with fresh fruit obviously means it'll no longer be fresh, it'll no longer get bought. But also bear in mind that once the initial shock is over with, we have a situation where we're trading on World Trade Organization terms. And what that means are tariffs and checks. That's particularly bad if you're exporting things related to animal matter. Live chickens or even dead chickens have to be checked at the border under World Trade Organization rules. And we export two-thirds of the food and drink that we sell in this country. What you might say, logically enough, is that's fair enough, but for imports, if we decide to drop all our tariffs so we don't have checks here, won't we get cheaper food? Maybe. You have to assume for a start that the people who sell this food on will give us the benefit of the cheaper prices, will pass them on to consumers, which is never guaranteed. But secondly, think of the farmers. If you're a beef farmer in this country, you might be able to go to a restaurant and have cheap Argentinian steak, but your ability to sell your own goods at home will be severely damaged, and that will have consequences for the economy too.